感谢赐了天父赐给我们美好的安息圣日。
Thank the merciful God for giving us this Sabbath day.
能够在我们的灵恩布道会结束的时候
，so that after the spiritual convocation,
大家能够很平安又过了一个星期。
That we are able to go through a week peacefully.
可贵的就是能够在安息圣日在这边共同相聚。
What's more precious is that we're able to gather here together.
回想我们在灵恩布道会的期间
，Looking back during the spiritual convocation，
传道人他用他的信仰的角度来勉励我们大家。
The preacher approached from his spiritual angle to encourage all of us.
用了耶稣就是最好的医生。
The topic that he used was Jesus was the great physician.
我想这是我们共同的体验。
This is something that we all have experienced in the past.
如果没有耶稣基督的拯救
，without the Lord Jesus saving us，
我想今天。有很多人不可能坐在这里。
Many of us would not be here today.
所以因着耶稣基督的拯救
，and because he's saving us，
因而感受到神主耶稣的恩典
，we are able to experience his great mercy.
啊，接下来呢，他在灵恩会当中也用道理来勉励我们大家。
The preacher also encouraged us with.
他勉励说在前在前的要在后。
He also said that those who proceed first will become last.
在后的要在前。
And the last will become first.
我想这个也值得我们深深的思考。
And this deserves our attention and us pondering on it.
今天是属我们是属于在前的呢还是在后的呢
?And what are you today? Are youthe ones on in the first or the one behind.
如果我们没有去思考的话
，and if we go through our life without much thinking，
也许我们是在前的
，you could be in the front。
那也许我们思考以后，也许我们是在后的
，maybe after you ponder this question， you might think that you are falling behind。
其实不管在前或者在后。
It doesn't matter that you're in the front or you're behind.
都做了我们极好的思考。
What you need to do is to do much thinking.
为什么呢
？And why is that?
因为主耶稣即将再来。
Because the Lord Jesus will come again.
也就是说，我们如果在前的话
，So what that means is if you're in the front,
你要当心你会被落在后面呢。
What you need to worry about is whether you're going to fall behind.
这是一种自我警醒的思考。
And this is a thinking that this is what you need to do to examine yourself.
那如果你是在后的呢
？If you're the ones that are falling behind,
你永远都得不到奖赏吗
？You will probably think that would I be rewarded?
也不见得你得不到。
It doesn't mean that you won't get it.
只要我们努力，主耶稣基督都会给我们美好的时间跟机会的。
As long as you're willing to make an effort, God will give you the time.
那再来呢？他又提到说呢，这个要叫他来仰望神。
The preacher also mentioned that to ask us to look upon God.
这就是一种传承啊。
And this is.Similar to passing down heritage,
在我们的信仰传承上也是重要。
It's important to pass on our faith to the next generation.
真耶稣教会是永续经营。
The True Jesus Church has been continuously going on.
神的国更是永续经营。
And God's kingdom has been continuously going on.
所以真耶稣教会跟神的国是并行的。
So our church and God have been walking parallelly.
是一样的。
We're the same.
那今天我们要趁着有光来行走。
So today, you must walk while you have the light.
这是主耶稣当时传福音的时候所讲的一句话。
And this is what Jesus said while he spread the gospel.
我们来看约翰福音的十二章。
Let's turn to John chapter 12.
约翰福音十二章的三十五节。
John chapter 12 verse 35.
十二章的三十五节。
John chapter 12 verse 35.
三十五节，这里主耶稣他这么说。
This is what Jesus said.
光在你们中间还有不多的时候，应当趁着有光行走，免得黑暗临到你们。那在黑暗里行走的，不知往何处去。
35, then Jesus told them, you are going to have the light just a little while longer. Walk while you have the light before darkness overtakes you. The man who walks in the dark does not know where he is going.
主耶稣在这边非常的强调，要趁着有光来行走。
Here Jesus stresses that walk while there is light.
那主耶稣又特别提到说，光还有不多的时候。
Jesus also mentioned that light may not last much longer.
表示光很快会过去的。
So what that means is the light will be gone soon.
就好比我们一天的时间，光的时间是有限的。
Similarly to our day, the day will go by fast.
如果没有趁着有光去行走
，If you do not walk while there's light,
那真的我们在黑暗中行的就有困难了。
Then you might have difficulty walking in the dark.
虽然今天我们的科学进步
，Even though technology is advanced.
三 C 的东西啊，很方便。
We have a lot of technology.
外面有路灯。
We're able to walk at night with the street lights on.
可是有一些人在黑暗的时候，他就不敢去行走了。
Some people might not be able to walk in the dark.
因为看不清楚。
Because you cannot see clearly in the dark.
尤其年长者，那更看不清楚。
Specifically for seniors, they are not able to see clearly in the dark.
所以今天我们生活在这个环境里头。
Being where you are today,
真的要趁着有光来行走。
You should definitely walk when you have the light.
那主耶稣在这里所强调的，给我们做什么勉励呢？
What Jesus stresses here, what kind of encouragement is it trying to bring up?
我们今天要去思考。
What you need to think is,
今天我们趁着有光要行走什么呢？
When you have the light, which direction should you head to?
那我今天趁着有光要如何去行呢？
And when you have the light, how should you walk?
这些都是值得我们去思考的问题。
And these are some of the questions that deserve your attention.
真耶稣教会强调的这是真理。
And what our church, the true Jesus church, stresses is the truth.
那我们看到主耶稣所讲的这些话
，and from the statements that's been made by the Lord Jesus,
也都是针对的真耶稣教会来强调
，are in line with what true Jesus church has.
你们都是神的儿女
，and we are sons and daughters of God.
就是我们大家都是神的儿女。
Even though we're sons and daughters of God,
所以神的儿女要趁着有光来行走。
So as sons and daughters of God, we should walk when you have the light.
我发现了，神给世上的人都有从逆境中做某方面的启示。
I discovered that we have been presented with challenges, and through those challenges, we are inspired somehow.
我们可以去思考。过去以色列选民出埃及走旷野路。
We need to think about how the Israelites walk through the desert.
有时候人们说云这个云柱、火柱可以来带领以色列百姓行走。
The pillar of clouds and fire led the Israelites.
没有错啊，云柱、火柱除了可以带领他们行走以外
，other than leading them and guiding them in the desert.
也可以给他们取暖，带给他们温暖。
They also provided much warmth and heat for them.
甚至有阳光，来被云彩把它遮住了。
The sun The sunlight was covered by the clouds.
所以从正面的角度可以看出来，原来云柱跟火柱都带给以色列百姓有某方面的一种安全感。
And looking from this perspective, the cloud, the pillar of cloud and pillar of fire have bring much security to the Israelites.
那从圣经可以看出来，过去这些选民他们所行恶的时候。
And looking at reading the Bible, you can see while the Israelites was doing evil things.
神也用了一种瘟疫来警告他们。
God used pestilence to warn them.
这种警告，说真的，有时候真的让人会受不了。
And the warning that was given from God, you might not able to withstand.
当我们深深思考以后呢，会觉得这是神他的一种爱的提醒。
If you give some thought to it, you will realize this is love coming from God.
反过来看我们今天的社会环境。
On the flip side, when you look at where we are at today,
今天我们生活的社会环境
the surrounding and the environment that we're in today,
现在极严重的就是这个新冠病毒这个肺炎的问题。
We're currently in a pandemic.
已经一年多，将近要两年了。
And the pandemic has been around for more than a year.
还无法完全平息。
We're still not able to eliminate the virus.
这个问题去思考之后
，After giving some thoughts,
应该也是给世人一种提醒。
This serves as a warning sign.
更是给真教会一种提醒。
This is also a warning sign for the true church.
为什么给真教会提醒呢
？And why did I say that?
所提醒的就是。当负的责任非常的重。
So this reminds us that we have been loaded with responsibilities.
时候到了。
The time has come.
因为光即将要过去了。
The light will pass.
黑暗临到的话呢，人就无法行走在黑暗里面了。
And when the darkness overtakes us.We are not able to walk anymore.
我想这两年的当中啊
，In the past 2 years,
我们会感受一件事情。
We all have experienced one thing.
疫情有时候很严重，我们大家没办法来这边聚会。
When the pandemic was severe, we weren't able to gather, congregate.
疫情缓和了就可以来这边聚会。
Once the pandemic has eased, we're able to come back in.
这就是一个时间问题。
This has to do with timing.
因为时间很快又过去的。
Because time will just pass by soon.
如果没有好好去把握。
If you do not grab onto the opportunity.
那你怎么去抢救人的灵魂呢
？How would you be able to save people's life?
所以主耶稣所讲的。
So what Jesus says here.
当趁着有光来行走。
Walk while you have the light.
就是对真教会一种提醒。
This serves as a reminder for the true church.
要真坚持在我们的真道上去行走。
We need to keep on going on the path.
所以呢，这个就是我们今天所要行的一个部分的。
And this is what I'm trying to remind you when it comes to walking in the light.
我们来请看诗篇的119篇。
Let's all turn to Psalms 119.
诗篇119篇。
Psalms 119.
第九节。
Verse 9.
十九篇第九节。
119 verse 9.
少年人用什么来洁净他的行为呢？是要遵行你的话。
Now, how can a young man keep his way pure by living according to your word?
诗篇的这座那提到说，少年人要用什么来洁净他的行为
？Again, how can a young man keep his way pure?
人是没办法去洁净自己的行为。
As a man, we're not able to purify our actions.
要洁净人的行为，就是要遵行神的话。
If you want to be able to purify your actions, you have to be able to follow God's words.
遵行神的话非常重要。
It's important to follow God's word.
哪里重要呢？
And why is that
我来举一个例子。
Let me give you an example.
在人类刚开始的时候，
At the start of the human being history,
就是记载挪亚他的后代。
It records the descendants of Noah.
当在地面啊来生养众多之后，
After he raised much,
结果呢？挪亚的后代呢？这些人怎么了？
And what happened to the descendants of Noah?
我们请看创世纪的六章。
Then let's turn to Genesis.
十二节、十三节跟十四节。十二节，神观看世界，便是败坏了，凡有血迹的人在地上都败坏了行为。十三节，神就用挪亚说，凡有血迹的人，他的尽头已经来到我面前，因为地上满了他们的强暴，我要把他们和地一并来毁灭。十四节，你要用戈木来造一只方舟，分一间一间的造，里外抹上松香。从刚才所看的这几节的经节，
From these verses that we just read,
这是当时挪亚接受神的话的前后一段经过。
Verses show that when Noah received the word from God,
首先神观看世界都败坏了。
God see how the world has been ruined,
在地上都败坏了行为。
There have been a lot of actions that have been frowned upon.
这就是脱离了神的话语。
And their actions are way out of line.
接下来呢，神就开始对挪亚说了。
Then God said to Noah,
既然人没有照我的话，现在就充满了血气了。
So when people do not listen to me, they follow their own desires.
那现在呢，人的尽头已经来到我面前了。
The end time for human has come.
因为世上的人都充满了强暴。
Because this world was filled with violence.
没有照我的话去做。
And they hadn't been following my word.
那现在呢，我要把他们一并毁灭。
And I'm going to destroy them.
这是神对挪亚所说的话。
And this is what God said to Noah.
要造方舟的原因。
And this is why Noah needed to build an ark.
那到十四节呢，神就告诉他说，要用戈木去造一只方舟。
And in verse 14 says Noah needed to build an ark.
然后一间一间的造。
He needed to build an ark one by one.
里外要抹上松香。里外。第六章十四节，最后。
So make yourself an ark of cypress wood, and make rooms in it, and coat it with pitch inside and out.
那从十五节以后啊
，Starting from verse 15,
神就告诉挪亚，你方舟要怎么去做
？God tells Noah the instructions in terms of how to build an ark.
这就是看出挪亚他对神的话的看重。
And from this, we can see how Noah valued God's words.
也可以看出挪亚是照神的话去做的。
And you can see Noah followed God's instructions.
也可以用今天的角度说，他行在神的话语这个真道上面。
And we can see that Noah has been following God's words and walked in his path.
当时的人来取笑了挪亚。
People at the time ridiculed Noah.
大白天太阳那么大，哪里会下大雨啊
？How will it rain when you have when it's so sunny outside.
挪亚完全没有被他们打动他的心啊。
Noah wasn't shaken by their statements.
挪亚就完全照神的话去做了。
He remained steadfast and followed God's words.
挪亚如果有自己的看法跟想法。
If Noah were to have his own opinions,
也就是说外面的人来给他影响之后的变化。
If he were to be influenced by the statements made by the other people,
真的咧，太阳那么大，怎么会有可能下大雨啊？
好，is it possible that it's going to rain because it's so sunny outside?
所以啊，从这种现象看出，挪亚是把神的话完全听进去的。
So from here you can see that Noah listened to God fully.
没有更改。
Without adding his own opinions.
完全照神的话去做这一艘方舟。
He built the ark according to the instruction from God.
所以今天真耶稣教会出现啊。
With the appearance of the true church,
也等于是挪亚当初造方舟的那个情境是一样的。
This is similar to the time when Noah started to build the ark.
有人在取笑挪亚。
When people ridicule Noah,
那今天也有人在取笑真耶稣教会。
And similarly, there are people out there that are mocking us.
怎么一直强调真呢？
People might say, why you keep emphasizing the word truth?
这种真耶稣啊，不是会很多让很多人来跌倒吗？
If you keep emphasizing the word true Jesus, would that make people fall?
所以今天的真耶稣教会所负的重责大任就在这里。
And this is the kind of responsibility that we're carrying.
就是完全照神的话去做。
And that responsibility is we are following the word of God.
这就是真道。
Then this is the truth.
这就是真理。
And that is His word.
所以呢，今天的真耶稣教会可贵的就在这里。
And this is why we are so precious.
要做成末世的一种拯救的一艘末世的方舟。
We should be the ark for the end time.
所以今天看到主耶稣对我们所讲的这些话。
And from the statements that God had made.
那又看到现在世间的这种情景真的对我们极大的提醒。
And comparing to what is going on in this world, all these serve as a warning sign.
所以今天的真耶稣教会就是要认真去想。
So what we need to do today is we need to be serious about preaching His word.
所以我们从灵恩会的当中啊，传道人给我们勉励的话。
Last week, the preacher encouraged us during the spiritual convocation.
在前头要在后。
But those in the front would fall behind.
这是极重要的提醒。
And this is a great reminder for all of us.
如果你一直用的在前的这种角度去自我安慰跟高兴。
And if you're satisfied with the status quo,
或者是自己为满足。
And if you're content with what you have,
我想这种在后的可能就有你的机会了。
And those who are falling behind are going to catch up.
那如果我们用在后的思考的话，
If youapproaching this phase, thinking that you're falling behind.
我们进行我们的责任。
And you do what's being given to you.
我们进行我们的努力跟追求。
You make efforts and you continue to pursue the faith.
有一天我们也会跑到前面去啊。
One day you're going to catch up and you're going to be the first.
这是属于神所悦纳的啊。
And it's something that God will be happy about.
所以今天的真耶稣教会都不敢松懈了。
And that's why you cannot relax as a true Jesus Church member.
要负起末世的拯救。
And this is a responsibility that we need to load up on our shoulder.
更是有这种使命感。
And this is a sense of mission that we should all have.
所以今天我们要趁着有光来行走。
And that's why you need to walk when you have the light.
就是要多多来传真道。
Which is to spread the gospel while you can.
其实我们在北美哦，尤其在我们加拿大这个地方啊。
In North America, specifically in Canada.
我感觉到我们的布道的机会不够积极啊。
I feel that we're not aggressive enough when it comes to preaching the word.
我想我们应该要把这种布道的机会应该要扩大。
What we need to do is we need to put more efforts and more human powers on it.
比如有魂茶会。
For example, we need to have tea.Gospel tea fellowship more often.
或者是用咖啡时间。
Or while you having coffee.
这透过大家静下来可以来谈福音啊。
You just need to make sure that you have some time allocated that you can spend time talking to people about the truth.
那教会有很多不同层次的年龄的信徒。
There are many...different age groups in our church.
有青年，有中间，有社青。
They're youth, they're young families, young couples, they're seniors.
更可以透过各个不同年龄层去把举办那种福音布道会。
And we can have different activities targeting different age groups.
或者是烹饪，或者是插花，都可以来举办布道团契。
Another example is,we can do is we can have maybe cooking fellowship or some kind of different activities to bring people together.
要多重管道、多重方式、多重角度去做福音的传播。
We need to approach this through different channels, approaching through different angles.
要让我们的同龄多有机会来参与这种布道的工作。
And we need to allow...everyone the opportunity to participate in preaching the gospel.
因为主耶稣交代我们。
Because this is what Jesus, Lord Jesus has told us.
要趁着有光来行走。
Walk when you have the light.
所以呢，今天我们不管什么年龄层。
So it doesn't matter what age group you fall in.
只要今天我们还有一口气在。
As long as you're alive.
都要把真道福音去传扬出去。
And this is your duty to spread his word.
所以我们已经看到这种疫情这么严重的发生了。
During the pandemic,
我一直是感想说神给真耶稣教会的一种礼物。
If you approach this from a different angle, you can see that this is a gift given by God.
为什么说礼物呢？
And why do I put it this way?
这是给我们做一种机会的一种延伸啊。
You can see that as an opportunity.
也给我们一种提醒。
And also as a reminder.
让我们能够抓住机会。
So that you can make sure that you hold on to this opportunity.
因为这种传真道的责任，如果我们自己有所掌握在我们手上的时候，
And if you're able to use this opportunity and to spread the gospel,
今天你就会感觉到，原来这种疫情是给我们有正面的教训啊。
Then you feel that this is actually quite a positive thing.
为什么说呢
？And why do I say that?
照理讲，正面的教训是医院人更多了。
Because during the pandemic, you see more people being hospitalized.
但是呢，有一些人靠祷告。
Some people, when they face challenges, they rely on prayers.
有一些人赶快自我来警醒。
Some people might use this opportunity as a warning sign for them to correct themselves.
因为有警醒，就懂得来靠祷告。
As long as you know how to examine yourself, then you will know how to rely on prayers.
过去曾经有位先知告诉我们
，A prophet used to say,
安逸无虑的人有祸了。
For those of us who are relaxed, you'll be in trouble.
我想我们住在这个北美，哦，加拿大温哥华这个地方。
When you're at East, you will be in trouble, especially for us living in Vancouver.
哇，大家都很安逸呀。
You feel so much at ease.
啊，政府给我们照顾好好的。
You're well taken care of by the government.
所以我们就没有深深思考神的国的重要。
Then you wouldn't think about how important God's kingdom is.
就没有去思考我们在行在真道上的这种积极性。
And then you wouldn't think about whether you are on the path of faith.
所以这种疫情就是给我们一种好像强身剂一样啊。
So this is much like a shock.
也可以说一种电击那样击来冲击我们。
This is like much like receiving a shock.
所以呢，如果没有的话，我们就麻麻痹痹啊。
If you don't have that kind of impact, then you're probably going to live your life numbly.
因为有这种缘故呢，我才说这是神给我们真耶稣教会的礼物啊。
And that's why I said this is what God has given us.
让我们都警醒过来。
So that we all can be awakened.
因为我们这么做呢，对我们都有好处啊。
Because if you do it, if you can do it, then that's positive.
我们来看传道书。
Let's turn to Ecclesiastes.
传道书十二章的十三节。
Chapter 12, verse 13.
十三节。
Verse 13.
传道书十二章十三节，这些事都已听见了，总意就是敬畏神，谨守他诫命的，这是人所当尽的本分。
13. Now all has been heard. Here is the conclusion of the matter.Fear God and keep His commandments, for this is the whole duty of man.
神用这种瘟疫来刺激我们世上的人。
God used this pestilence to awake us.
尤其刺激真耶稣教会的统领。
Specifically to awake the members of True Jesus Church.
这是告诉我们要来敬畏神啊。
This is to tell us that you need to turn to God.
啊，敬畏神的是我们每个人当尽的本分啊。
And to worship God is our duty.
所以今天我们能够行在这个真道上啊。
So when you're able to walk in the path of this,
我们能够来尽个人的本分。
You need to carry on this duty.
我想这是神所悦纳的美事啊。
And this is pleasing to God.
因为今天我们活在世上
While you're still alive in this world,
我们懂得耶稣基督对我们每个人的勉励
We understand the encouragement coming from God.
在马太福音第五章的十六节这边说到
If you turn to Matthew chapter 5 verse 16,
在我们的信仰生活上面啊
In our faith, in our life of faith,
我们要去做荣神益人的事情啊
What we need to do is to honor God and do things that are beneficial to people.
能够把这些荣神益人的事情，把这些的荣耀都归给我们天上的阿爸父啊。
So all of which we need to present it to God.
这个就是我们要尽的责任啊。
And this is our duty.
这种责任虽然是我们个人的尽本分的做法。
So we need to do it as our duty.
其实这些是个人。得赏赐的一个机会啊
！And in a way, that's how we will be rewarded.
看起来好像行在我们的教会、我们的团体里面。
We need to do this for the people at the church.
其实是对我们个人都有益处的。
And this will edify us.
因为我们常常有一句话。哦，有一些老一辈子的常常说了哈，做主公不落空啊。
Some of the elders, you might have heard this before. If you're willing to do the holy works, you will receive the eternal blessings.
如果今天我们有抱着这种使命感
，If you have this kind of sense of mission,
我们为了将来可以进天国得赏赐。
And you'll be able to enter the eternal life and be greatly rewarded.
那今天我们尽力去做，那又有什么关系啊
？So what that you make some effort.
所以今天我们不管 是属于什么语言上面。
It doesn't matter what kind of languages you know.
我想呢，这是神给我们每个人的机会啊。
And this is an opportunity given by God.
我最近几年有一个感想。
I've been thinking.
这个感想不知道对不对，我不知道。
I'm not sure whether it's right, but this is my thinking.
最近几年呢，带慕道者最多的，我感觉到是在本拿比那个区域最多。
Look in the past, I feel that we have a lot more truth seekers at the Burnaby Church.
所以因而后来就决定了在本拿比那边买个会堂。
In the Burnaby area, and that's why we decided to purchase a chapel in Burnaby.
当然这个是只是一种我个人的这种浅见而已啦，看法而已啦。
And this is just solely my own opinion.
我要讲的我个人的感想说神有他的眼睛在看。
What I wanted to tell you is God is watching.
我们的神是真神，是活神啊。
Our God is true and living.
所以慕道者在那边很多，当然就必要在那边买个会堂啊。
So when you have so many truth seekers in the Burnaby area, that makes us to purchase a chapel over there.
圣经告诉我们了。
Bible tells us.
这应该也是主耶稣所讲话。
And this is what Jesus said.
如果我们遵行去行神道的人呢
？If you follow God's path,
是有福的啦。
You will be blessed.
所以今天呢，我们可以看出在神面前行他的道理是有他的必要性啊。
And that's why it's absolutely necessary to follow God's path.
所以今天我们也要从圣经去学习，我们该如何去行。
And that's why you need to learn from Bible so that you know which path and how to follow this path.
刚才我提过有很多可以去进行的福音布道会的各种不同的机会。
And previously, I mentioned there could be different opportunities or different fellowship that we can put together.
我想在这些布道会的主轴的内容
，and in terms of the content of the fellowships,
应该是行在主的道路上。
We need to focus on how to be on the path of God.
应该是一种敬拜神的一种方式。
In a way, this is how we worship God.
所以我们可以从古时候的约书亚看出来。
So we can see from Joshua.
在约书亚记的24:15里头记载。
In the book of Joshua, chapter 24, verse 15.
当时那些选民呢、啊、
？The chosen people.
他们有个人的信仰的方向跟角度
，had their own opinions when it comes to faith。
所说的意思就是说，他们有不同的信仰的神呐、
啊。So they all worship different gods。
那个时候的耶稣也呢，他就在选民面前就强调一句话
，and that's why Joshua stressed in front of them that。
我们看约书亚记24:
Let's turn to Joshua chapter 4, chapter 24,
15节。约书亚记24:15。若是你们以侍奉耶和华为不好，今日就可以选择所要侍奉的，是你们列祖在大河那边所侍奉的神呢、啊？是你们所住的这个地的亚摩利人的神呢、啊？那至于我和我家。我必定侍奉耶和华。
15. But if serving the Lord seems undesirable to you, then choose for yourselves this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your forefathers served beyond the river or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are living. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord.
所看耶稣呀所说的这些话。
So looking at the statements of Joshua,
是在选民面前 表示他的信仰立场。
This is to express his faith before the chosen people.
为什么年老的约书亚要在选民面前来讲这些话呢？
Why Joshua, especially during his at the latter age of the aging Joshua, would want to say that in front of the chosen people?
至于我，我都要侍奉耶和华。
He says, "As for me and my household, we will serve the Lord."
因为耶和华这个神就是我的神。
Because the Lord is my Lord.
难道他身边的人不知道约书亚所敬拜的是什么神呢？
So didn't they know that what kind of God Joshua worshipped?
所以从这里可以看出约书亚他的立这个跟选民所立的这种约定。
So from here, you can see the proclamation that Joshua made to his people.
我从年轻一直到现在。
From when he was young till now.
我现在已经年老了。
Now I'm old.
我还是跟我的年轻一样来侍奉敬拜这位耶和华真神。
I continue to serve the true living God as I was younger.
可以看出呢，耶稣呀，他一生一世都行在主的道路上面。
And you can see that Joshua followed the Lord wholeheartedly in his whole life.
因为当时的选民，他们的信仰真的太复杂了。
Because the faith of the chosen people has been falling behind.
所以呢，这个时候呢，约书亚才有必要在选民面前特别强调这件事情。
And that's why he made the statement that he made for the people.
那今天呢，我们也一样啊。
Similarly, we're in the same situation.
我们看到传道人对我们所勉励的话。
And what preachers have been encouraging us.
要让我们的后代一样的可以来仰望真神。
We need to make sure that our descend, our next generations can continuously to worship the true God.
所以传道人对我们勉励的话
，So the encouragement from the preacher
跟耶稣亚当时在选民面前所承诺的话都是一样的。
It's similar to the proclamation that Joshua made to his people.
要让我们的后代一生一世都完全敬拜这位真神。
We need to ensure that our next generation and generation to come will continuously to worship our true living God.
这个就是今天我们所要行的真道。
And this is the true, this is the true, the faith that we need to be walk on.
今天我们行这个真道就是敬拜真神。
To be able to walk on this faith, then that means we're worshiping God.
这个敬拜真神也是非常重要啊。
And it's truly important to worship the true God.
我们来看啊，古时候一位先知领受神的话。
And I'm going to talk about and prophets who received the word from God.
那都在选民面前特别来提醒、来安慰、来带领。
And specifically, talk to the chosen people so that they can be guided.
我们看以赛亚书五十一章。
Let's turn to Isaiah 51, chapter 51.
以赛亚书五十一章第三节。
Isaiah chapter 51, verse 3.
三节。
Three.
耶和华神已经安慰锡安和锡安一切的荒场，使旷野像伊甸，使沙漠像耶和华的园有。在其中必有欢喜快乐感谢和歌唱的声音。
Three, the Lord will surely comfort Zion and will look with compassion on all her ruins. He will make her desert like Eden, her wasteland like the garden of the Lord. Joy and gladness will be found in her, thanksgiving and the sound of singing.
这是神透过先知以赛亚对以色列百姓的勉励。
Through prophet Isaiah, God encouraged the people.
神应许赐福给锡安。
God promised that he will give his blessing to Zion.
当锡安领受神的应许的福的时候，
when Zion receive God's blessings,
就会有不同的改变。
They will be transformed.
所以就在第三节就开始说，锡安的荒场会使旷野像伊甸那样。
That's why it says in verse 3 that it will look with compassion on all her ruins.
荒场旷野会像伊甸。
He will make her deserts like Eden.
伊甸是一种快乐欢喜的地方。
Eden represents a place with joy.
也是感谢跟歌唱的一种代表。
Also means joyful and a place with singing.
那都会使沙漠会像神的原有，在其中必有欢喜快乐歌感谢和歌唱的声音。
And her wasteland, like the garden of the Lord, joy and gladness will be found in her thanksgiving and the sound of singing.
也等于是说神透过先知来做讲明的话。
And through the prophet, God was able to explain.
你敬拜神，神就应许来赐福给锡安地上的人民。
If you seek God, God will in turn provide His blessings to Zion.
那就会带来欢喜、快乐、跟感谢、跟歌唱。
What comes along with that is the joy and gladness, thanksgiving, and sound of singing.
所以今天呢，我们从传道人给我们勉励的话。
So from the encouragement from the preachers,
它的重点就是要叫我们跟我们的后代世世代代都能够来仰望真神。
The point is for us and our generations to come, that we can continuously on the path of worshiping God.
因为世上的光真的快过去了。
Because the light in this world will pass soon.
如果没有赶快抓住机会，
and if you do not hold on to this opportunity.
也许时间到，我们这种信仰传承说不定就断了。
Highly possible that when the time comes, you might not be able to pursue.
所以从这种机会，我们要更积极的去趁着有光去行走。
So when you still have this opportunity, we should be more aggressive and we should continue to walk in the light.
好让神的话这个真道能够永续经营。
So it allows God's word can continually be embedded within us.
因为我们的神养育我们。
Because our God raises us.
因为我们的神看顾我们。
Our God looks after us.
因为我们的神将来要拯救我们。
Our God eventually will save us.
所以呢，这种恩典啊，我们不能忘啊。
And you cannot, definitely cannot forgive.What he had done for us.
我们要把这一切的恩典来让我们的子子孙孙都永远享受在神的恩惠里面。
And we should pass on his mercy to our generations.
早上我们就分享美丽到这边了。
And I conclude my service.
我们来唱诗。
Let's turn to hymn book.
394首。
394.
感谢神。
Thank God.